Hey guys, it's Dave from DC Fit. I've got a couple of great guests with me today. We've got Willie Tonga and Janice Blackman, a couple of our superstar ambassadors. We're going to come back in about 3 minutes, but while we're gone, I'll make sure you got a drink bottle, you got a towel, you got a chair to do the exercises with us as well. While we're away, this is a great chance just to share the video, tag your mates, and get everyone you can involved in the session. I'll talk to you soon.
While we're doing things a little bit differently at the moment, you can now get your 715 health check from home, meaning it's the deadliest way to keep your health on track. Complete your health check via video teleconference or over the phone, and you'll get your hands on one of the deadly shirts. So be deadly and live healthy. Book your telehealth appointment now at any participating community controlled health service.
Everyone needs to get their flu shot this season, particularly for elders and people with chronic diseases and their households. It's really important to get your flu vaccine as soon as possible. So call up your local community control health service to ask about your free flu shot. Plus, you'll take home a deadly choice of scarf or a beanie.
It's almost time to get your annual flu shot, and the messaging we're sending out loud and clear is phone first. So your clinics are coming up with lots of different ways to deliver flu vaccine. Many of those will be done outside of the clinic space. So we'll have marquees outside. We're going to have drive-through flu vaccination clinics. So that means you coming in your car, parking up, getting your flu jab, returning to your car, and waiting 5 to 10 minutes before you drive home.
Healthy habits are the best way to keep you operating at 100%. So maintain a healthy diet and try to keep active as much as possible. Remember, good eating habits are a deadly choice.
So there are some people in the community who are more vulnerable to COVID-19 than others. And that can include people whose immune system is already depleted. It can include people who are on certain medications which reduce their immune response. It can also include people who have certain infections already, and COVID-19 can increase their risk. And it can also include people who've had cancer treatments, as well as people whose own immune systems, for some reason, may not be working as efficiently as it should. And we have a duty, particularly not to expose those people to unnecessary risk.
Hey guys, welcome. First of all, I'd like to acknowledge the traditional owners of the land that we gather on today. I'd like to pay my respect to elders past, present and emerging.
Perfect.
Dave?
Thanks very much, Willie. So guys, just as we went through last time as well, these exercises are all generic. If you've got any special considerations or special conditions, make sure that you're modifying these exercises yourself. We're going to go through two levels, a harder level and a bit of an easier level as well. Make sure you're just picking the most appropriate one for you. If you do need any specialised advice, make sure you go and have a yarn with your appropriate healthcare provider, okay? And then if you have any questions or anything like that, make sure you just pop them in the comments, and then we'll address them as we're going through as well. So as we all know, the DC Fit program is a physical activity program aimed at our Indigenous communities all across our Queensland, where we get out, get back into nature, and we get everyone out there doing some exercise, playing games, doing physical activity in a safe environment. And the main thing about it is that we're all going to be having fun while we're doing it as well. So before we get started today, we just got to make sure that, just like in every other thing we do in life as well, that we're washing our hands and that all of our equipment is nice and clean. And we're going to announce the winners of our clean and deadly comp at the end of the session today. So make sure that you stay tuned. So we're just going to wipe down our equipment before we get started.
Yes.
Perfect. All right, Willie, can we have a yarn with you before we get started, my man? Perfect. So with these current times that we got ourselves in, what have you been doing at home to stay fit and active, mate?
Yeah, Dave, I just keep it simple. Obviously, the gyms are closed, and I want to try and replicate what I do at the gym. So if I'm doing weights and I want to do a pull-up, say, for instance, this is a beam at home, so in the backyard, so I'll do pull-ups on a beam, just my normal push-ups, or if I want to make it harder, then I'll put my feet up on a step, do my push-ups there, and then just do, body squats where, touching your glutes to a chair, or you can hold weight, or you can, put some weight in a bag and then to make it a little bit harder and, challenge yourself a little bit. But, I keep it simple.
Perfect. I think that's the best way of the sort of things we can do as well. If we're keeping it nice and simple, I'm overcomplicating it. What's your favourite thing? What's your favourite one exercise to do at home?
I'd have to say pull-ups, because it targets all your muscles in your upper body.
Yeah.
I'm still working on, my legs. I've done a bit of damage in my legs, so that's still something that I need to work on.
Yeah, a bit of rehab, that sort of stuff. We've got to make sure we're keeping those muscles nice and active.
Mm-hmm.
After your a 20 years of playing football and that sort of stuff, we've got to make sure that we're keeping everything moving.
Yeah, definitely.
That's really important for our guys at home as well. I just to remember that we still got to try to get at least our 30 minutes of our physical activity in every day. It doesn't matter if we're doing the gardening, if we're walking the dogs, if I'm out there going for a surf. For those of us who are lucky to be by the beach, I'm making sure that we're just getting at least our 30 minutes of our physical activity. If you can, are trying to do it. I'm out in your backyards, down in your local environment. But if you are stuck inside, a DC Fit's going to be like a really good example of some ways that we can still do our physical activity. I'm in our lounge rooms, in your bedroom, that sort of stuff as well. So it doesn't matter where you are, we can still make sure we get all of our 30 minutes in for the day as well. So that's good. Willie, that's a mad shirt, bros. What can you tell me about it? Where'd you get it?
Yeah, this is one of the new Queensland State of Origin shirts. So obviously, because of the times that we're in, we can't go down to the medical clinic. So now we can get it through telehealth.
Yeah.
Just ring up or, go online and,
sweet.
Get your health checked and get one of these shirts or one of the other NRL shirts that we're partnered with.
Yeah, it's really important when we are doing like our telehealth appointments or when we are going into the clinic, I'm always make sure that we're calling up beforehand. And so if you do have a bit of a fever-like symptom, you got a bit of a cough or you got something else and you're not quite feeling right, before you go into any of our community controlled health services, I'll make sure you're calling up and then there'll be some staff at the front door doing a bit of concierge work as well. All right, so let's get started with some of our exercises for today. So what we're going to be doing, we're going to be doing what we call a 5-minute challenge. So we're going to have a 5-minute rounds. In those rounds is going to be our 4 exercises, and we're going to go through all of those as we're working. But before we do that, it's always important that we do a warm-up. Doesn't matter if you're out there on Suncorp, I'm out there with Willie, out there playing a softball at the Olympics like Janice, or you're at home, exercising, in your bedroom, always make sure that you do a warm-up. So we're going to get started with that now. All right, so up we get, guys, and off we go, eh? So we're going to get started with our 30 star jumps. Yep, and off we go. Our 30 star jumps for us. All right, perfect. That's got the heart and lungs nice and warm. Now we're going to do 20 arm circles. So it's going to be 10 forwards and 10 back for us.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
10? Yeah. 10 and 10.
3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8,
9, and 10. Perfect. And now we're going to do 10 lunges up. We're just going to warm up those legs. So we're going to do a 5 on the left and 5 on the right. So I will do 5 on the right first. Off we go. So 1, that's it, and back. 2, perfect. 3, 4, and 5, and then change over to the left side now. So 1, that's it. Good work, Willie. And back. 2, 3, 4, and then 5. And then we're going to go straight back into the 30 star jumps for us. Off we go again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, and our 20 arm circles, so 10 forwards, 10 back. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and backwards. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and our 10 lunges. All right, so 10 left, 10 right, 10 right first. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then 5 left. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Perfect. You guys feeling nice and warm? Yeah. That's what we want. All right, guys. So we're going to start off with our first round. So all of our rounds are going to go for 5 minutes. And the first one's going to comprise of these are 4 exercises. So I'm going to talk about them, and we're going to get these guys just to demonstrate them for us and make sure we got the right techniques, and then we're going to get straight into it. All right, so the first one is going to be our 5 push-ups. So just want to guys demonstrate a push-up for us. Yep. Yep, so 1, that's it. So with the push-up, I'm trying to keep the back nice and straight, elbows out the back, and that's perfect, all right? Just trying to keep your head always looking that little bit in front of you. Perfect, Janice. And our second one's going to be a 40 high knee stationary running. Yep, yep. So get those knees up nice and high. As you can see, with Willie being a pro athlete, he's got good spring in the legs. So if you're not quite getting that high at home, that's okay. As with everything DC Fit, always just doing the best that you can. All right, and our next one is going to be sit-ups. So as you can see with Janice, she's going for like a medium level one here. She's got her hands up by her head, and she's getting her whole chest and her whole upper back up off the mat. If you want to make it a bit harder, Janice, you're just going to lift your feet up into the air. There you go. And make sure you're keeping your knees nice and close together. Up you go. Perfect. That's it. Up you go. That's it. One more. Perfect. And if you want to make it a bit easier, Janice, I pop your feet on the ground, and you're going to pop your hands on your legs, and you're only going to come halfway up. So that's going to be like our easiest level for that one as well. Perfect. And then our fourth exercise is just going to be the high knee stationary running. So this one's going to be a really high cardio session. So are we good to go with that, guys? Everyone at home, good to go? And the 5 minutes starts now. Off we go. So 5 push-ups. 2, 3, 4, 5. There we go. So we're going to make sure we go together, and the 40 high knees, off we go. So for those of you doing it at home, doing the best you can, trying to keep up with these guys. If you can't quite keep up with what these guys are doing, and we get to the next hat, you can either keep going through at your own pace, or you can just jump through with us as well. Or if you're faster than our 2 elite athletes, 40. Yep, perfect. All right, 10 sit-ups now, guys. So picking your appropriate level. Feet off the ground if you feel confident. Feet on the ground if you want. Off we go, Willie. Yep. 1, 2, 3. Perfect. So if these guys are going, if you're going a bit faster than these guys at home as well, you can just keep going until they finish, and you can keep up with our timing as well. Perfect. A good job, Willie. And that's 10, Janice. Yep. Up we go. So you got your 5 push-ups.
No, high knee running.
I'm trying to cheat you. Off you go. Don't listen to me. That's it. Make sure you're getting those knees up nice and high. Okay, faster with the arms, Janice. Faster with the arms. Perfect. That's it.
Okay, push-ups.
All right, now up to your 5 push-ups. That's it. Keep that heart rate nice and high, guys. Keep it working. Keep that back nice and straight. Perfect technique, Willie. That's it. High knee running again. Back into your 40. That's the way. Don't trip, Janice. That's the way, guys. I hope everyone at home's getting a good workout in, getting that heart rate up nice and high. Keep going. Beautiful. 10 sit-ups. That's the way, Willie. So make sure you're keeping those knees nice and close together. That's going to work your core a bit harder. A good job, Janice. That's it. Keep going. A 40 high knee running again. Off we go.
Cardio.
You wrote this, Janice. Perfect. Guess what's next? Back to the push-ups, guys. Everyone working at home, make sure you keep going. Make sure you're trying to keep up with these guys. If you can't, that's all right. Keep those backs nice and straight, elbows out the back. That's it. Make sure your head's looking a little bit forward. Perfect. And back to your high knee running, guys. 2, 1. Off we go. That's it. Keep those knees up nice and high, Willie. All right, guys, into your sit-ups. That's it, doing it, going through at your own pace, making sure you're getting the best exercises you can for all your mob at home. Keep working. High knee running. That's it. If you need a drink at home, that's all right. But make sure you get straight back into it as quick as you can. And off we go. Yeah. 2, 1, go. Cool. You guys feeling all right?
Yeah, just like cardio.
That's it, back to the push-ups, eh? That's it, guys. Almost there. The last 3 seconds of the workout, and you're done. Great work, everyone at home. Hope you're working as hard as these two elite athletes. Make sure you're just doing the best that you can, okay? And now we're going to have a quick rest, have a quick break. I'm going to explain the next exercises while you're grabbing a drink, okay? So the first exercise that we're going to do here is going to be mountain climbers. With the mountain climber, make sure that we can keep our back nice and straight. It's keeping your back nice and straight, and then we're just going to bring the knee up to the opposite elbow. So knee up. The first speed is just going to be nice and fast, a 1 foot always in the air. If you're starting to get a bit tired, just make it nice and slow, okay? As long as you're working the best that you can, that's all that we care about. Our next one is going to be jump squats. So with our jump squats, keeping our knees over our feet, arms up in this position, going down, just like you're going down to sit on the toilet, and then you're going to jump up into the air. So down nice and slow and exploding up, okay? If you're getting any pain in your knees or your back, what we can do is we can just take that back down to just an air squat, okay? So that's going to be our level one. Our jump squat's going to be level two. Pardon me. Our third exercise is going to be burpees, okay? So we're going to do 5 of those. So the burpee, start with the jump. Down we go. Fell out of my pocket. Could they hear any of that? Yep. All right, guys, jump squats. Off we go. Yeah, that's it. So picking your level. So Janice has got the jump squats. Willie's got the air squats. I'm making sure you're doing the most appropriate level for yourself at home. So with Janice, she's doing real well. She's getting down nice and low and she's popping up. So it's down nice and slow and explode up. As you can see there with Willie, he's getting to that all the way standing up position, which is really good. All right, burpees is our next one. So down we go. Perfect. If you're finding burpees is a bit hard at home, what you can do is you can do your push-up up against the wall or the kitchen bench or on a chair. And then jumping up as high as you can. The most important thing with everything at DC Fit is that you're doing the best exercise you can personally, okay? That's it. And now we've got our flutter kick, so we've got 20 of those. Off we go. So making sure you're squeezing your core while you're doing this. That's it. Otherwise, you can get a little bit of lower back pain. I'm all about doing things right here. All right. 20 mountain climbers. We're back around for this one now. Off we go. That's it. So knees to the opposite elbow if you can. Keep that intensity working. Keep that heart rate up. This is a really tough challenge, this one. Off we go. All right, 10 jump squats. Off we go. Exploding up, Janice, that's the way. There's a fly ball trying to get over the outfield. You've got to really jump up as high as you can to get it. That's the bottom of the ninth. Just got to make sure you save that run. That's it. We'll go with 9. So we got, that's 10. And those of you mob working at home are trying your best to keep up, which is really good. All right, burpees. Up next, team. And get it. All right, guys, doing real good. We're onto your flutter kicks now. This is going to be the last exercise of this round, and then we're going to call it at that, okay? All right, guys, I finished off nice and strong. Perfect. How are we feeling? That's it. Great job. Great job, those. Hope all of you guys working at home are still getting a good workout in this as well. As you can see, our elite level athletes are really getting huffed and puffed with this one, so it's a tough challenge. Now, you can all thank this young lady down here. She was the one who actually wrote this, who created this session. So if she's finding it really difficult, there's no surprises. Some of us at home might be finding it really difficult too. All right? So while we're having a rest, getting our drink in, I'm just going to go through our exercises for the next round. So our first one for that, all right, is going to be 25 squats. So once again, air squats is going to be our base. So keeping our knees nice and straight over our feet, going down like that, okay? Getting down to as low as you possibly can, and then really trying to explode up out of that nice and straight up position. So you're really going to be forcing yourself out through the hips. Our second exercise is going to be dips. So what we're going to do here is going to be going down like this. Our first level, our knees nice and straight, down. I'm all the way down until your bunti almost touches the ground. If you want it a little bit easier, you're just going to bend those knees and support yourself through your body down like that. The most important thing with these are tricep dips. So we're trying to target that muscle on the back of the arm there, is that your elbows are keeping nice and close to your body. You're not going out to the side, then your chest and your back starts coming in, but it's elbows to the side. Exercise C is going to be 15 crunches. So what we're going to do with this one, really going to focus on keeping our knees together. Doesn't matter if your feet are on the ground or in the air, it's going to come up. And then our fourth exercise is going to be our glute bridges. So what we're going to do here is having your feet a shoulder width apart, pressing up like that. If you want to make it a bit more challenging, is that you can lift a 1 foot up into the air like this from the start, or I go up with 2 feet and then do 1 foot kick. Down, 2 feet, a 1 foot kick. Okay? Now, because I went and touched a Janice's seat, and we're all about being clean and deadly here, is I'm just going to give that a wipe down. I really want to win some of those prizes for the clean and deadly competition, so all got to try to do our bit here. All right, guys, are we ready? All right, 25 squats. Ready, get set, go. More. 22, 23, 24, 25. All right, I'm onto our dips now. So making sure you're picking the right level for you. With our crunches for the next round, guys, if you want to make it a bit more challenging, I try to get a bit of a sideways movement into it too. And off we go. So 20 dips, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I make sure you're going through at your own pace. 8 for Willie, 9 and 10. I'm trying to keep up with these guys here in the studio. If you can't quite keep up, that's perfectly fine. I keep count of what exercise you're up to, and then I'm on our next round. I try to get one better. All right, onto our crunches now. So if you're feeling confident, I try to put a little bit of a sideways movement in there as well. If not, I keep it nice and simple. That's it, off we go. Most important thing with these crunches is we're going to try to keep those knees together. That's the way. Really going to work that core today. Off we go. That's it. Keep going. That's it. And one more for Janice. And she's done. All right. Our glute bridges is our next one, guys. I'm really trying to pick that right level for us. So if that's 2 feet on the ground, and off we go. The most important thing here is we're getting those hips up nice and level, and keeping them up off the ground. 7, 8, 9, and 10. Great work, guys. So I reckon we can get through one more round of that with a little bit of change. So up and at it for your 25 squats. I make sure we're keeping through, and off we go. That's it, getting that best bit of exercise for you guys at home is the most important thing that we can focus on here. Keeping that technique nice and straight, keeping your back up a bit higher for us, Willie. That's the way, keep that back nice and strong. One more. All right, 20 dips. We're gonna feel that burn in the triceps. So for you mob at home, keeping your elbows in nice and close, and off we go. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Great job. That's it. Janice is just going to finish off her last couple. 18, 19, 20. Perfect. All right, so crunches are up next. You got this, Janice. You wrote this.
I know.
This is all on you, girl.
So I can't. I'm not complaining.
And so keep going. So knees together is going to be the most important thing we're going to focus on here. And off we go. If you feel confident, as you can see with Janice, as she's starting to put a little bit of her obliques into this one as well. So she's getting her opposite elbow up to her opposite knee, which is really good. And then Willie's just sticking with the traditional one there of having his feet up on the ground and working really hard. All right, my glute bridges. Four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. That's the way, guys. Really good technique there. That's a great control. I'd say we've got 50 seconds. We're going to see if we can get through our 25 air squats in that time, which I reckon we should be able to smash out. And then we'll get a little bit of dips in there as well. So off we go. Go. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. That's it, almost there, 20 seconds to go. 21, 22, 23, 24, 25. Oh, great work. And now we've got 20 dips in 15 seconds. Can we do it? Race against the clock. All you mob at home, make sure you dig it in. This is when it's going to burn. Keep going, Willie, keep going. 7 seconds, can you get it? All you guys at home, make sure you're working as hard as Willie is, and you're done. Guys, a great job. Make sure we're getting in a drink. You're all working super hard, which is really special to see. This is some of the best exercises we've had at DC Fit yet, so you should be proud of yourselves. All right, up for our next round, what we're going to do up here. All right. Make sure we're resting up because our last one's going to be super hard as well, okay? So I'm just going to go to that other angle for us too, guys, so we can see it better. So our first exercise is going to be 10 leg raises. So what we're going to want to be doing here, hands up beside your head. We're just going to raise up and then back down to that neutral position and up and up and up, okay? As you can see there, and my shoulders are off the ground. If you want a little bit easier, I take your head down, and you can even, I just have a 1 foot up. Make sure if you're doing that, you're really squeezing into that core. So you're trying to suck your belly button down into your spine. So it's going to be holding it in there, and just up and down, and nice and slow. So we've got 10 of those. Up next is going to be 20 plank up downs, or a commando push up, depending on what you want to call it. So arms up nice and straight, elbows and up, elbows and up. So with that 20, we're going to do a 10 leading on your left arm and then 20, and then a 10 leading on your right arm. 30 alternating lunges. So alternating means we're just going to go left to right, left to right. So it's one, down and back, two, down and back. With these, really going to try to focus on keeping your hips nice and level as well. So a bit of a tip to do that, I'll help you control yourself, hands on your hips, down, lowering it. If you're not that confident with this movement, down and lowering it, okay? I'm making sure that just because we got 30 and you're only getting 20 in, I'd prefer 20 really good quality ones rather than 30 gammon fast ones as well. And then our last one, a 40 frog squats. So a frog squats, elbows tucked in between your knees, up and down like this. Trying to get that bunty up as high into the air as you possibly can. Okay? All right. Now we've all had a bit of a drink. I've had a bit of a rest. 20 seconds, then we're going to get going for our last set of exercises. So this is going to be our last 5 minutes. We're going to give it everything you possibly can. How are you feeling, Janice? Just remember, you wrote this. And 3, 2, 1, and we're off. That's it. Good work, guys. Make sure we're keeping that core nice and strong. Kind of keep that back nice and flat on the ground. As you can see there, ladies and gentlemen, Willie bought a pair of shoes just for today. They're brand new. Keep pushing. And Janice has got her avocado socks on as well. Yeah. And he's doing extras. All right, guys, now we've got our 10 plank up downs or our commando push-ups. So you can choose Which side you want to start on first? And off you go. One, two, three. There we go. That's the way, keep pushing. Now the most important thing here, as you can see with Willie and Janice, is that they're keeping their bunties down. You don't want that bunty getting too high up. You don't want to look like a pyramid. So keeping that back nice and straight. That's it, Janice, keep going. Speaking of pyramids, keep pushing. Everyone's doing real good at home. You should be real proud of yourself, so keep pushing, keep pushing. Only 3.5 minutes to go and then you're done with your exercises for the day. A 30 alternating lunges is coming up next. So up you get, Willie. That's it, guys. Just over 3.5 minutes to go and then we're done. That's it, dropping it down. I'm keeping that technique nice and strong. I'm keeping those hips nice and level. I keep your back upright. We don't want to start leaning forwards. And that's when we start to get a poor technique and we can get back injuries as well. So going down, if your knee is touching the ground, I'm making sure it's just a very light tap. You don't want to be thudding that knee down to the ground. So as you can see with Janice, she's getting that knee. I'm all the way down for a light touch. If we've got some gamma knees or you've got a bit of a back problem, we can kind of go like what Willie's doing, and he's just working within his own personal limitations. So there's nothing wrong with either of these two techniques. The most important thing is that you're getting the best you possibly can for yourselves at home. All right, so we must be getting pretty close, I reckon.
Five more
each leg for Janice. That's it, guys. Keep going, keep pushing. All you mob at home, I make sure you're working super hard. As you can see, these guys are starting to battle and the pace is starting to slow down. So there's nothing wrong with that at all. Keep pushing, keep pushing. All right. Into the frog squats. Ready, steady, go. So 40 frog squats. That's the way. That's it. Faster, faster, faster if we can. Good job. I keep those elbows tucked in. I keep that back nice and straight and trying to get that hamstring as straight as you can, so trying to get that bunty as high into the air as you can, guys. Keep working. If you need a break halfway through these exercises, guys, as you can tell with our elite level athletes here, they're having breaks too. So just make sure, like we keep saying, you're just working as hard as you possibly can. You're not racing Janice, you're just racing yourself. Under 90 seconds to go, guys. We're going to see if we can really smash out this last 90 seconds, and then we're going to have a big break and then do a bit of a cool down and some stretches to finish off while we have a yarn to Janice about her softball career. So keep going. Just over a minute to go. Back to our leg raises, guys. We're going to see if we can get through the leg raises and start into the plank up downs, and then that'll do us. All right, Janice, I reckon that's your 40 there. Good job. 50 seconds to go. All right, so 10 leg raises. And off we go. That's it. So as you can see there, both with Willie and Janice, what they've done is they've tucked their hands in under their backsides. That then helps their backs stay nice and strong and supported. If you have your hands out to your side a bit wider, you can become a little bit unbalanced and you can hurt yourselves. All right, so 20 plank up downs. Can we get it in 20 seconds? The race is on. Off we go. So try to smash through as many as we can. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. That's it. 5 seconds to go. 4, 3, 2, 1. And you're done. Everyone, that was a great effort. Super hard work there. As you can see with these guys, they are absolutely exhausted. I'm here at DC Studios. So everyone doing this session at home. I should be super proud of yourselves. You've all done a deadly workout. And this is your 30 minutes worth of physical activity done for the day. And now you can relax. So one of the beautiful things about a Facebook Live these days is that you can then go back on and you can watch this video tomorrow. I tag your friends in it as well. I make sure that they're getting on and that they're doing these exercises with you. That can be one of the great ways that we can stay connected as part of our community these days. So tagging your mom up in Cairns, Mount Isa, Gold Coast, doesn't matter where you are. We've all got internet these days, and we can all stay connected through that. So what we're going to do, while these guys are cooling down, I'm just going to go through and do some stretches. All right. So Janice, do you want to take us through for a first stretch, my friend?
Yeah. So, sorry, everyone. So first one we'll do, because our legs are a little bit jelly, we might lay down and then do a nice quad stretch. Ooh, and then we'll hold it for about 30 to 45 seconds, however long you need. And we'll let that leg down, let it go for a little bit. We'll roll over and we'll do the other leg. So holding it again for about 30 to 45 seconds. Alrighty, we'll bring it back over. Alright, this is probably one of my favourite ones. A nice good hammy stretch, so we'll sit up. You want to sit up for me, Willie? And then we'll put one leg out, tuck the other leg in, and then reach for our toes. It's okay if you can't reach for your toes. Go as far as you need to. We'll hold that for about 10 seconds, and then you shouldn't be feeling any pain on this. You should be just feeling a very light stretch in your hamstrings. So then after 10 seconds, we might push it down just a little bit further, if we can go a little bit further. We'll hold that for another 20 seconds. Alrighty, and we'll come back up. And we'll go the other leg, if we can. I can't complain, I do love a good leg session. All right, we'll hold this for about 10 seconds. Again, it's okay if you can't touch your toes. Go as far as you need to until you get a nice stretch on the hemis. All right, and then we'll go down, pull it a little bit more. Hold it for another 20 seconds. Alrighty, and we'll come back up. And then the next one, we might do a bit of glutes. So we might do a pigeon. So on this one, I want you to bring your leg up and cross it over. Have your knee on the ground. So your choice, whether you want your hand, whether you want your hand on your knees or on the ground, your choice. My personal preference is on the ground. And what I want you to do is try to push your chest towards your leg. All right, and you should be feeling a nice, good stretch through your glutes. And we'll hold that one for another 20 to 30 seconds, sorry. Again, you shouldn't be feeling any pain on this. It should be just a nice, light pull on your glutes. Make sure we're breathing through this as well. Shouldn't be holding your breath through stretches. Should be having a nice breathe out. That should release the muscles a little bit better. All right, we'll come out of that one. We'll swap legs, same thing. Up to you what you want to do, whether you want your hand on your knee or on the ground. And then again, pushing our chest to the ground. And again, shouldn't be feeling any pain on this stretch. Just should be feeling a light pull. Again, make sure we're breathing. Hold it for another 5 more seconds. And 3, 2, 1, and we'll come out nice and slowly. When you come out of stretches, try not to come up too fast. Ooh, all right. And this one, so you might need a chair for this one. This is a good one to stretch your shoulders slash back and a little bit of your lower back. All right, what I want you to do is put your elbows on the chair And same thing, I want you to try to push your chest towards the ground. You should be feeling it right in your shoulders and the back of your shoulders. If you can, maybe if you can, put your hands towards your shoulders a little bit. You should be feeling a nice stretch straight up your triceps into your shoulders. Again, shouldn't be feeling any pain in this. And make sure we're breathing through it. All right, we'll hold it for another 5 more seconds. 3, 2, 1. And we'll come up nice and slowly. All right. I know about you guys, but I'm pretty good. But if you need to do any more stretches, feel free to while I bring Dave back into it.
There you go. Oh, great job, Janice. While we're doing that, we might just have a yarn with you, for a sec. So you just want to jump up for us, Jan?
Oh, God.
Ooh. That's all right. How'd you find that workout?
Oh, you know, I guess all my DC Fit clients are probably like, yeah, good job. Like,
yeah. That's all right.
But, you know, it was a tough one. I can see why everyone looks at me when I walk into the room for a DC Fit room and goes, oh, no. Yeah. So that's very much understandable.
Yeah. So where do you run the program?
Out at Moray Field. So we run it at Divine Sporting Complex. So it's a little bit hidden. So if anybody knows where the Moray Field State High School is, it's actually just up the road from there. So it's not too far. It's walking distance. And if you told me you walk, I will count that as your warm-up from the train station. Not saying I believe you, but you can give it a go.
You been getting good numbers there?
Yeah, good numbers, nice consistent numbers. But, you know, the guys work hard no matter how much numbers I get. We're getting a good consistent 5 to 10 at times, so it's good.
It's a good starting spot for the program there, isn't it?
Very much so, you know, like how often do you really get a free PT session, you know?
That's exactly right. And that's one of the beautiful things about the DC Fit program is that it's all free, okay? So this program isn't going to cost you any money. You get all of our deadly DC Fit merch as a part of your incentives as you keep coming along. Now, speaking of merch, as we talked about before, we had our clean and deadly competition winners. So we got our 3 lucky guys out there in the community. I get to win one of these hoodies. So our three winners for today are Vicky Hardacker Jackal, Callie Wozniacki, and Nikki Adams. I do apologise if I mispronounce one of those names, but as a prize, you're going to get one of these deadly Cowboys jackets. Now, Janice, while we've got you here, mm-hmm. How have you been staying connected with your family? Because I know you're all scattered across Queensland.
So my mum and dad are actually based in Mount Isa. And my sister, at the moment, she's in Mount Isa due to, you know, all the COVID-19 stuff. But, she's actually based in the city when she's usually here. And then I've got my brother and my sister-in-law and all my nieces out in Hervey Bay. And then, you know, I'm in Moray Field, so yeah, we're a bit scattered around. Luckily, I do have my grandmother and my grandfather in Caboolture as well, but you know, with all the stuff going on at the moment, I'm also a single mum, so and I've got a little 3-year-old, so it's a little bit dangerous for me to kind of take him over there, but that's the joy of technology these days, I guess, with Facebook and, you know, Instagram. My mum, she added me on Snapchat the other day. Like, I'm assuming my sister taught her how to do it. I don't know how I feel about it, to be honest.
There we go.
But, you know, it's a good way to stay connected. You know, that is the joys of technology today. So it can, there's a lot of pros and cons to it, I guess.
Yeah.
You know, and that is one of the pros to it. You know, I get to stay connected with family all over Queensland right now.
Yeah.
So, which is good. Yeah.
So for those of you at home, don't know Janice, she's an elite softball player. So are trying to make the Olympics now for Tokyo 21. Mm-hmm. What can you tell us about your physical preparation and then how it might have changed with the COVID-19 going on at the moment?
Yeah, so it's a little bit hard for me, I guess. Ever since I became a single mother, I guess I've been kind of used to, I guess, training away from the girls and, you know, not being in the gym as much as with them, but I still get to do skills training with them, but obviously not at the moment. So for me, I guess I'm a little bit used to it, trying to self-motivate, I guess, and finding that motivation at home and with that routine of being a single mum and having a little 3-year-old, I guess, is routine is a really big thing for me. And I am also lucky enough to still have my job. So I guess, with that keeps my routine still in check. So yeah. Then nothing gets kind of chucked out of whack. Not too much anyway, except for the fact that, you know, can't do morning sessions at my usual gym I usually go to. I guess that's the only difference, which is a little bit sad because you don't really get to socialize. I know,
yeah.
You know, you do crave that little social interaction a little bit, but it's not too bad. I guess
yeah,
it's you get used to it. I mean, you got to adapt, right? Like
yep.
You can't really help these things. You know, I'm not a doctor, I'm not a nurse, so I can't really say how long it's really going to be. You're just going to have to adapt to it, I guess.
Yeah. And then with that as well, like you kind of touched on technology, and even though we are a bit isolated, we can still do like a watch party. We noticed a few people doing watch parties on Facebook the other day, and then they were all doing the DC Fit session mm-hmm. apart, but they were still together as well. So that's really good. But what can you tell us about your work that you've been doing at our health clinics as well?
Mm-hmm.
What have they been doing? I'm out there in the MAT6 regions.
Yeah, so right now they've got the Deadly Choices officers actually out the front for concierge. So if you come to Morayfield, you'll see my face sitting at the front. even if I wasn't there, I'd still be on the clinic, so you still get to see my face either way. So yeah, we're just being a concierge, I guess, guiding people in through the clinics. If they have any symptoms or anything like a cough, sore throat, any fever-like symptoms, we usually take a seat outside our clinics, or they can get a choice to sit in their car in the, we've got the nurses and doctors doing yeah. triage for them. So that helps quite a bit, especially when you've got all these little babies in there. But yeah.
That's it. Yeah. So we've got the flu shots out there. And the flu shots are going to be available at all of our clinics. One last thing, just before we go, tune in next week as well. We're going to have a couple of DC Fit sessions and a good quick tucker session as well. So you all have a deadly long weekend. We'll talk to you soon. How are you feeling?
Good. Good, actually. Awesome. Yeah.